classroom. For example, suppose we take this is a glass slab. Take it as a glass slab. And suppose one side is silvered. Suppose this side is silvered. Right? Take it as a numerical. That's better. The thickness of glass slab T is equals to, we take it as some 10 centimeters. Okay now? And here, this is the unsilvered surface. From the unsilvered surface, I'm taking the object here now. At a distance of u, means from this surface, at a distance here equals to, actually that is not u, okay, I take it as from the unsilvered surface, some d equals to, take it as some 20 centimeters, okay. Where the image will be appeared from the silvered surface and from the unsilvered surface, if they ask now, or else suppose from here, from this surface, okay, from this surface, take it as some AD, from the surface AD, where the image is formed, okay?
Incident anedi perpendicular ga unda some where distance where la unda sir angle la chesala unda sir.
Actually, the incident rays, they make some angle, Nama. But keep in mind, everywhere in this chapter, the angle of incidence here is always small. Okay? Throughout the chapter, we take I is small. Why? Because to use the formula mu is equals to sin I by sin R, we write it as I by R. Am I right? So here, those rays are very close to the normal, making very small angle. Okay, and they bend towards the normal, incident on this one, and forms here. Means my question is, first of all, for this surface normal, I think object is not appeared here. Why? Because object is in rarer medium. So like a bird is at certain height, the bird will be appeared at a apparent height of, remember that concept, if the height is h, then the bird will be appeared at a height of h dash equals to mu into h.
Yes,
we discussed it previously. Am I right? Excuse me. Take the refractive index of this medium as some mu is equals to, better I take it as 5 by 4. Nana. Okay. So that calculation will be easy for us. Mu is 5 by 4 into h is how much? 20. H is the distance from the surface now. 20. That is equals to, I think I am getting 25 centimeters if I am not wrong. Okay. Is it clear now? So object is at what distance? 25 centimeters from the surface AD. Okay. So for the mirror, if you see, this object is at a distance of not actually 30 centimeters. Am I right now? From the mirror. From the mirror means this silver surface, this is 10. And this is 20, total actually 30.
Yes, sir.
But object is appeared to be at a distance of not 20, this is 10, plus this distance is 25. So object will be appeared from here to there, till here. How much distance is that, Nana? 10 plus 25, that is 35 centimeters. Okay. Since it is a plane mirror, the object distance is equals to on the other side, the image will be appeared at a distance of 35 centimeters. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Other side 35 centimeters means here this is on the other side. Of course, you can say this much part. On the other side, image is at a distance of 35 centimeters.
Yes.
Okay. So from the mirrored silvered surface, the image will be appeared at what distance? Suppose this is silvered surface A dash, B dash. Okay, Nana? So first answer, I think, over. From the silvered surface. Silvered surface. The object, the image distance will be, already I found that this is 35 centimeters. Okay, Nana? Now you see, are you following, Nana? Shanmuga?
Yes, sir.
Means my intention is, the image of unsilvered surface behaves as object for the silvered surface.
Yes, okay.
The image of silvered surface behaves as object for the unsilvered surface.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, who is the image? This is the image actually for us. Image is at a distance of 35 centimeters from the silvered surface.
Yes, sir.
Are you able to follow or redraw the same diagram here?
Right.
So, this image is now behaves as object for the unsilvered surface. Okay. Object for the unsilvered surface means from the image to the unsilvered surface, what will be the distance, Nana? This is 35.
It's 35.
And up to here, what is this distance?
10, sir. 45, sir.
So that will be 45 centimeters. Okay. So object is at a distance of 45 centimeters. Means this time for the unsilvered surface, the image will be appeared. Image. Okay. Image of silvered surface will be appeared. At a distance of, now the light rays after reflection, they are coming in the denser medium or rarer medium, Nana?
Denser, sir.
Denser medium means if the object is taken in denser medium, the distance will be appeared at a distance of T by mu. Remember this formula, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Here T means don't take the thickness, Nana. The distance of object for the unsilvered surface. How much is that?
45.
So here I have, right? This is equals to 45 by mu. Mu is how much? 5 by 4. Okay. Cancellation 5 9s. This 4 take will be taken to the numerator, that is 9 4s are 36 centimeters.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So here, second answer, from the unsilvered surface. The unsilvered surface. Okay. The image will be appeared, the image is formed at a distance of, how much I have to write here, Nana?
36.
Yeah, very good. At a distance of 36 centimeters. Oh. So is it clear, Nana, when the glass slab is silver? So this model is also over. okay, and here suppose I think on concave type of lens we did not solve any numericals. Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
So here suppose if you take one example related to concave, okay, better I take the combination. This is one convex lens, Nana. Half focal length, f is equals to take some 20 centimeters. And here I am taking one concave lens. Okay. Half focal length, f is equals to say some 30 centimeters. And they are separated by a distance of this distance, take it as 60 centimeters. Okay. And now the object is taken at a distance of u equals to say some 10 centimeters. Okay. So after refraction from the concave mirror, what will be the distance of image? Final image. Distance of final image from the second lens means concave lens. From the concave lens equals to how much? This is the question. Okay. So is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, here I think even you also can start, Nana. This will be some easy type of question only. This is okay. So solution, if we go to here, first of all, for I think the image of convex lens behaves as object for the concave lens. So image means, first of all, how to find the image distance, Nana?
By f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v minus 1 by u equal to 1 by f, sir.
Right, good. So here sign conventions, I think no need to say. U is negative and focal length of convex lens is positive. Okay. I quickly try to find out this one. Nana. Plus 1 by n is equal to 1 by 20. That implies p is equal to 1 by 20. Minus 1 by 10. I think
minus 2, sir.
Minus 20, na? Minus 2, na?
Minus 2, on kunta, sir.
20 is the LCM, kada? 21, sir. 10, 2, sir. Minus 1 by 20, kada?
Yes, sir. Minus 20, sir.
Right. So, answer will be minus 20. So this is image of whom, Nana?
First mirror, I mean convex.
Right, convex lens. So image of convex lens is formed at a distance of, that implies image is formed at a distance of minus 20. Minus 20 means I think image will be formed on the same side, Nana?
Yes, sir.
So at minus 20 means I think somewhere the image will be formed. Somewhere, yeah. Its distance is, he gave it as 20 centimeters. Okay. Now this image behaves as object for the concave mirror, concave lens. So that object distance will be how much now for the concave lens?
60. Plus 20, 80, yeah, sir.
So object distance now I have to write 80 centimeters. That is again left side of the mirror. Left side of the mirror means again minus. Okay. Here this is concave, Nana. So focal length is equals to, I have to write plus 30 or minus 30. Minus 30 centimeters. Concave kada. Okay, that implies again where the image is formed. 1 by v minus 1 by u equals to 1 by f. focal length negative to negative. Okay, we will substitute in the values. 1 by V minus 1 by U is minus 80 equals to 1 by F, that is minus 30. So we are going to get 1 by minus 30 minus 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 plus taken to the other hand, that becomes again minus 1 by 8. So both are negative.
240 by 11.
8 to, yeah, you are right. So minus 11, I think.
So minus option.
Right. So image distance from the final image is formed at a distance of V is equals to minus 240 by 11.
21.81 recurring was that, sir.
Right, good. So here, this is again, I got negative now.
Yes, sir.
So again, the final image is formed on the left-hand side only, somewhere here. This is the final image. I dash.
Sir, 1 minute, sir. Daddy phone me asked, sir. Put it
on. Right, sure. So again, we are going to start, Nana. Next one. Suppose here I take two lenses, Nana. Okay. The two lenses, I can take convex or concave. Okay. Any type. So better concave, Nana. Why? Because many convex models we saw. So I'm taking here, suppose this is one concave lens. Okay, take it as one concave lens. Off focal length, F is equals to here, say 30 centimeters, and refractive index as usual, mu is equals to 3 by 2. Okay, now? So take it as one. So mu is equals to 3 by 2. Right.
3 by 2, sir?
3 by 2. Okay. And here, it is actually kept in contact with another concave lens. This is second concave lens. Kept in contact. Its refractive index is also mu is equals to, take it as 3 by 2. Okay. And here, this focal length F is equals to, say, 60 centimeters. Okay, Nana?
Yes, sir.
After keeping them in contact, both you consider equiconvex lenses, Nana?
In same radius.
Same radius. And the gap between two lenses, after keeping them in contact, some liquid. Okay. This gap is filled with a liquid of mu is equals to 4 by 3. Okay. Now, I think you can understand this concept. These two lenses are kept in contact, and in addition, after filling with the liquid, I think you can say this is appeared like one biconvex lens. Am I right?
So, yes, sir.
Altogether here, it is appeared like one concave lens, one convex lens, and another concave lens. I think they are appeared to be kept in contact.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, kept in contact means if you know the focal lengths, it will be very easy. Nana. 1 by F is equals to straight away kept in contact in the previous.
1 by F1 plus 1 by F2 plus 1 by F3 and so on.
Yeah, very good. Here, 3 are there. So, directly we can write. Dimensions also we can substitute. This is concave. So, focal length he gave 30. So, I put minus 30. No problem at all. And this is also concave. So, F3 I can write it as minus 60. So, only problem is we have to find out the focal length of second one. Okay. And for the second one here, if you see this surface, Nana, particularly, this surface is actually the surface of first one. surface of first one means its radius of curvature. I don't know. I have to find out. How to find, sir? Using the focal length formula. 1 by f is equals to mu with respect to a by 1 minus 1 into, actually I have to write 1 by r1 minus 1 by r. Okay, and both are equal, nana. Directly I think we should not subtract, we have to substitute the sign conventions. I think you can say for the first one the radius of curvature coming left side, so it is negative or positive, nana? Okay.
Negative.
That is sir, negative. Yeah.
Sir, net wall ochcha. So the connection.
Ah, okay.
That is the connection. Sorry.
Here the radius of curvature of second one, I think it is positive. Okay. So it is positive means all together. If you substitute the two values here, right?
I mean convex by convex.
Yeah. For the second one also, and for second this one, we can write similarly. Means my intention is the radius of curvature is exactly equal to focal length. So here also similarly, I can write the radius of curvature of second lens will be R2 is equals to 60 centimeters. Why? Because its focal length is 60 centimeters. Now I think you can find out the focal length of second lens, nana, water lens. Water lens focal length means 1 by F2 is equals to, you can find out. This is water lens. Inside water, okay. Outside we consider as air.
Yes, sir. 4 by 3
1 by R1.
Minus 1 by R2.
Minus 1 by R2 is minus 60. R2 radius of curvature, left side it will, you will get. Huh?
Yes, sir.
So minus 60. So I think you will get this is 1 by 3 into 3 by 60. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
After taking LCM.
1 by
60. 1 by F2 is equals to 1 by 60. Means F2 is equals to 60 centimeters.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, effective focal length 1 by F is equals to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2 plus 1 by F. Okay?
Yes, sir.
1 by F1 means take sign convention, minus 30. Why? Because that is concave lens. This is convex. Convex means focal length is positive. So plus 1 by 60, that is positive. Plus 1 by here, this is 60 minus 60.
Minus plus cancel, minus 1 by 30.
Yeah. That implies 1 by F is equals to minus 1 by 30. Means F is equals to minus 30 centimeters. Correct? This is the focal length of the combined lens, nana. Combined lens. So when the gap between the two convex lenses is filled with water. Okay, this gap is filled with water. So same question they may ask in exam even like this also, nana. Means this is one convex lens, biconvex lens. It is kept in contact with another convex lens.
In between that.
In between this gap is filled with water.
Yes, sir. Appudu rendiki convex iskoni madhyalo danu manu concave iskoni.
Very good. First one convex, third one convex, second one is concave.
Yes,
okay, na? By that you can solve the answer for this question.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. These are two models related to filling the gap between the two lenses with some liquid. Next to here, another model is, suppose it is one convex lens, nana, one lens convex or concave, something we are taking here. Okay. And suppose you are taking the object on the principal axis, no problem, nana. Here you are taking the object. But problem is in between the object and the given lens. If you take a glass plate, then what happens? Suppose this is glass plate of certain thickness.
Plane mirror, that's like slab, sir.
Like a plane, parallel sided glass slab. Plane glass slab.
Slab, sir. Slab, this slab, sir. Reflection.
Refraction. By the refraction, what happens? Here, suppose bends towards the normal and again away from the normal, like this, it will come. Okay? Inside bends towards the normal, outside again bends away from the normal. So, after refraction, what happened? The rays coming towards the lens, they appear to come from somewhere here.
Yes, sir.
Means my doubt is, originally object is placed at this distance now. But for the lens, object is appeared at this distance.
Yes, sir.
Means object position, is it shifted or not?
Yes, sir. Shifted, sir.
Shifted from O to O dash. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
That shift, if you are able to find out, then you can find out the position of image. Why? Because you suppose I'm giving one numerical, Nana. Say suppose this is 40 centimeters. Okay. Take a focal length of this lens as 20 centimeters. Okay. So here where the image is formed, if they ask, of course, since it is a convex lens, I will try to use the formula 1 by V minus 1 by U equals to 1 by F. Okay. But I think object distance is not 40 centimeters. That is 40 minus something. This part I have to subtract. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
That part is the shift. Shift in the glass slab is equals to, previously we discussed in parallel sided glass slabs, Nana. I think you remembered. T into 1 minus 1 by mu. Remember this shift formula?
Yes, sir.
Object, suppose one object is taken inside a glass slab, then the object will be appeared towards the surface and apparent depth will be T by mu.
Yes, sir.
Original depth is T. So shift here. T minus T by mu, that is equals to T into 1 minus 1.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is our formula here to find out O dash now. Shift. Okay.
Thickness refraction.
I'm giving that. Thickness, you take it as say some 1 centimeter, and refractive index you take it as 5 by 3. Okay. Mu is equals to 5 by 3. O dash is equals to 1 into 1 minus 1 by 1 by 5 by 3. 1 by 5 by 3 is 3 by 5. 2 by 5. Is it 0.4 nano?
Yes, sir.
0.4 centimeters. Okay. Then I will get U is equals to how much? 40?
Minus 0.4.
That is 39.6.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is U now. That U we have to substitute here. That implies 1 by B minus 1 by... And a sign convention, don't forget it. Minus 39.6 is equals to 1 by F is 20. So you have to do some calculation. 1 by 20 minus 1 by 39.6. Okay. So V will be 20 into 39.6 divided by after taking LCM and reciprocating this equation. 20 into 39.6 by 19.6. Is it correct?
Yes, sir. Huh? Yes, sir. 40.4.
Something. Okay. Right. 40.4. So this is the value of V.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear, Nana?
Yes, sir.
This is one model. Right?
Yes, sir.
And here they may ask the combination of two, Nana. Combination of two means like one convex lens to one concave mirror. Suppose this is one convex lens. I think you can solve this model, Nana. You try it for tomorrow. Huh? This is a focal length. F is equals to say some 40 centimeters. And object is taken at a distance of from pole, Nana. U is equals to, I am giving here 60 centimeters. Okay. And I am taking here one concave mirror. Okay. At a distance of 100 centimeters from the first lens. Okay. And its focal length, you take it as 20 centimeters. Right? Here, the method I am telling here, Nana, once you listen, first of all, you have to find out the location of image, Nana.
Yes, sir. 1 by V minus 1 by U equal to 1 by F, sir.
Means
object la use outsum, sir. 1 by F.
Very good, very good. Object for the mirror.
Yeah.
Again, 1 by V plus 1 by U equals 1 by F here.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And again, it forms one, after reflection, it forms one image, Nana. Forms one image somewhere here.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This image again behaves as what?
I prefer this.
Lens again. Okay. Object for the lens means where the final image is formed. Suppose final image is formed here. Okay, I don't know. I am just assuming final image. What is the distance of final image from the lens?
Sir, apudu U and the A avutundi sir mottam I1 nunchi aa mirror konde length kada sir apudu.
In which case, Nana? First case or second case or third case? Sir?
Last case, lo, sir.
Last case, lo, this is I1 for the mirror, na?
Yes, sir.
Suppose you form that I1 from the mirror as means V2. Okay,
okay sir.
Suppose you formed it as some 30 centimeters, Nana.
Sure.
Then what is the object distance for it?
70, yeah, sir.
Obviously. By taking it as 70, where the final image is formed.
Okay, sir, I will do it, sir.
And in the same way, first time, suppose you form the image here of lens.
Sir.
Suppose you form that is at some, say, 60 centimeters. Then what is the object distance from the mirror?
No, sir.
This is 60 from the lens.
Yes, sir.
Then what is the object distance for the mirror? Total 100, Nana, you see here.
Yes,
total 100 means what will be the remaining distance from here to there? That's what I'm telling. Means here, take care, Nana. First, by taking the object distance as 60 centimeters, try to find out the image position.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that image is at how much distance from the mirror? Okay,
yes,
this is object distance for the mirror, U2. Okay, now,
yes,
whereas this is U1, from this U1, you found V1 from the lens.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Using the formula 1 by V1 minus 1 by, of course, left side. So, minus U1 equals to 1 by F1. Okay? By this, you will find V1.
Yes, sir.
So, I think V1 is not the object distance for the mirror. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Then 100 minus V1 is the object distance.
Yes, sir.
From this again, you have to find out the image. Suppose image is formed here. This image distance, how to find? 1 by?
Sir, V1 achi 120 osun, sir.
V1 120 osun, right? I don't know, Nana. Actually, I did not calculate. 1 by V1 minus means plus 1 by 60 is equals to 1 by 40. So, 1 by V1 is equals to 1 by 40 minus 1 by 60. No, 120, yeah?
Yes, sir.
240. I think you are right. 120. That implies correct. 120. V1 is equals to 120. Nah?
Yes, sir.
V1 equals
to 100.
Yeah. Then you have to take here the image location. Already, why? Because you calculated that one. Better you take the image location here. Not there. You will get the image location beyond the mirror. Am I right? Beyond the mirror, somewhere here. You will get. Somewhere here means here. So this will be object distance for U2 is equals to, I think, 20 centimeters.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That too is beyond the mirror. So plus 20 object distance. Then you have to find out 1 by V2 now using the mirror formula, not lens formula.
Yes, sir.
Concave mirror focal length positive, U2 already positive. So you have to find out V2.
Sir, zero, sir. U2 minus F2 just.
Means minus 1 by U2, that will be V2 equals to infinity.
Sir.
V2 is infinity means after reflecting the rays from here, they come parallel to each other. Means after reflection from the mirror, final image is formed at infinity, na?
No, sir. No, sir. Final image is not, sir.
You got here 1 by V2 is 0, Gadana, na?
V2 infinity.
Infinity means what?
Up to object or chi infinity ane
artha deeniki. Its image is at infinite distance means for the mirror, so for the lens, object is at infinite distance.
Yes, sir.
Object is at infinite distance means finally the rays will focus to which point?
Focus.
Yep. So the final image is formed at F. F means its distance. Focal length is how much?
40, sir.
So our final image is formed exactly at its focus, 40 centimeters.
Yes, sir.
So is it over, Nana? This is one model, Nana, in the lenses. Likewise, you can find many models, Nana, in the lenses. If we discuss, we can find number of models here. Lens displacement method means this is object to point of view. Lens displacement method. In this method, Nana, main thing is generally we fix the lens at one fixed position and we change the object distance. Okay. Accordingly, object distance means U. We change U. Accordingly, V will be changed so that we move the screen to find out the image. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So we change the positions of object and the position of screen these two positions will be changed continuously, and we can find the image at a different position somewhere here, like on the other side. Okay, but in lens displacement method, what happens? This distance, object and screen, they are fixed. He won't change the positions of object and screen. Okay, that distance you take it as some L, distance between object and screen. This is fixed. But here we try to move this lens. Okay, means what you are doing, sir? First time, suppose I place the lens here at this position. I assume this is the first position.
Yes, sir.
Okay, means this is U1. Means for this object, whatever I am taking, suppose if I take some height to the object, okay, this is the location of object, then final image will be formed, I think, somewhere here by drawing the diagram native like this. On the screen, image will be formed, okay, inverted image. And that image distance, generally we take it as V1. And from these two, you can write the formula 1 by V1 minus 1 by U1 minus U1 is equals to 1 by F focal length. So that we can write 1 by V1 plus 1 by U1 is equals to 1 by F, equation 1. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And U1 plus V1 is equals to L.
L.
Uh-huh. Okay, now this lens is shifted to some other position, suppose here. Okay, and that displacement is suppose D. Okay, this is the
same. Sir.
U is changed, right? U1 plus V1 L, and the second time you are saying that suppose this is U2 and this is V2, you are telling that U2 plus V2 equals to L.
Yes, sir.
Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And you can observe there, totally this is L. Sum of two numbers is, suppose I say, 8 plus 2 is equals to some 10.
Yes, sir.
2
plus
okay.
8.
I have to write 2 plus 8 is equals to also 10. Right? But you can argue, sir, not only 2 plus 2, even 7 plus 3 also 10. Why should I take the same numbers in reverse order, sir? For that, what I am saying, second time what you write the lens formula, 1 by V2 minus 1 by U2 minus U2 minus of minus plus plus U2 equals to 1 by F. Okay, in this equation, if you change the denominator numbers, you won't get the same F here.
Yes, sir.
That's why V1 should be here. Whatever you took V1, here V1 should be equal to here U2. Okay, understood. This V1 should be equals to U2. And U1, here U1 should be equals to V2. Understood that point, Nana? Okay. So clearly here U1 is equals to V2, and I am writing V1 equals to U2.
Sir, Sir.
Only at two positions you will get the real image only, Nana.
Okay, sir.
You should get here the real image. Means after passing through this one, you should get real image on the screen.
Okay, sir.
If you move to some other position, you will get virtual image.
Yes, sir.
That is the problem. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
So here from this, U1 in the diagram clearly observe, Nana. U1 plus D equals to U2. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
U1 plus D. This part 1 to 2. D equals to U2.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So here one more equation I am writing. u1 plus d is equals to u2. Okay, na? And in the same way, v2 plus d is equals to v1.
Yes, sir.
V1 is nothing but v2 plus d. Correct, na, na? So here what I am writing, v2 plus d is equals to v1. Okay, no? From this you can find out some relation between v1 and v2 in terms of L and D, na.
Yes, sir.
Okay, means what I am saying, v2, sorry, u2, can I write it as v1, na?
U1 plus D equal to V1.
U1 plus D equals to V1. And U1 plus V1 equals to L.
Yes, sir.
Okay, na? Means what I am saying, D is equals to V1 minus U1. Correct, na?
Yes, sir.
And there, U1 plus V1 is equals to L.
Yes, sir.
So by solving these two, I think you will get 2v1.
Yes, sir. 2v1 so, equal to?
That implies v1 is equals to how much I will get?
L by 2.
L plus d by 2. By. Correct, na?
Yes, sir.
This is v1, na?
Yes, sir.
So v1, finally what I got? L plus d by 2. Okay, so this V1, if you substitute in the first equation U1, oh, it's almost, okay, we will try to complete it quickly now. U1 is equals to L minus V1 from this first, from this equation here. Are you seeing?
Yes, sir.
So U1 is equals to L minus V1.
Yes, sir.
Okay, minus V1, here substitute, Nana, you will get U1. L plus D by 2.
L minus D by 2, sir.
That's what I'm saying. So, U1 is L minus D by 2. V1 is L plus D by 2. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Substitute these two values in the first equation or second equation. First equation is better one, Nana, here. This one. 1 by V1 plus 1 by U1 is equals 1 by F, we got, na?
Yes, sir.
So, 1 by V1 means 2 by L plus D. Plus 1 by u1 is 2 by l minus d is equals to 1 by f. Okay. So 2 common. After taking 2l by l square minus d square. Correct, Anana?
Yes, sir.
Is equals to how much?
1 by f.
Then our formula, focal length is equals to L square minus D square by 2 twos of 4. 4L. This is the focal length.
Yes, sir.
Of the lens used. Okay, Nana?
Yes, sir.
And magnification?
V by U, sir.
Either V1 by U1 or V1 by U1. V1, U1 already you know here.
Yes, sir.
You will get L plus D by?
L plus D
by.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Nana? Magnification in the first time.
Yes, sir.
Magnification second time means V2 by U2 we have to write.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Nana? So V2 by U2 means V2 is what?
U1.
U1 by U2? U1 by V1, how much you will get?
What?
V1 by U1. Sorry. U1 by V1.
V2 by U2, that's sir.
V2 by U2 is, V2 is nothing but U1. Na?
Yes, sir.
V2 is U1 and U2 is V1.
Yes, sir. L minus D by L plus D.
That's what I'm saying. L minus D by L plus D. This is the magnification second time.
Yes, sir.
Then look at M1 and M2.
The reciprocal, sir. M1 equal to 1 by M2.
So can I write M1 into M2 equals to 1?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is what I'm saying. So M1 is height of image first time divided by height of object
into
height of image second time by height of object will be same. I am not changing the object position.
Yes, sir.
Equal okay, to Lana. Equals to 1.
Yes, sir.
That implies height of object in numericals. If they ask, what do you write? Cross multiplication. H O square equals
H I
1 into H I 2. Then H O is equals to root of
H I 1 into H I 2.
That's what I wrote here. So understood, Nana?
Yes, sir.
These are different equations related to lens displacement method.
Okay, sir.
Okay, Nana? Ippadike problem chali, two time teesesukunnanu. Okay.